Oh, we have a special midweek bonus coming to you from Jet City Turbines.
Okay, we've got a bunch of scrap turbine parts here. We're developing tooling for the AI-25 Russian or Ukrainian turbofan engine. And here is the HP turbine disc with all the new blades going back into it, laid out in matched pairs, which I've explained before in how to balance a turbine rotor. But that's not why we're here. Why are we here in the shop on the weekend?
Okay, the reason we're here on the weekend is because we got a special box in the mail, and this is the last thing I got in the mail, and it's from Jacksonville, Florida. It's from Daryl Bunn Studios in Jacksonville, Florida. And this is from Port St. Lucie, Florida. In Florida, again. I don't know why I have more fans in Florida, it seems, than anywhere else, but it's a cool place. I've been there once and I enjoyed it. So let's see what's in this box. First of all, it says, thanks Agent Jay-Z for all you do and good luck on the new Jet City. And that's where we are right now. We're in the new Jet City turbine shop. This is from Drew Coverstone. And it's got some goodies in it. Pratt&Whitney mug with almost like the unofficial slogan of my channel. Is that in focus? I hope so. Very cool. Awesome. Very nice. And it's got an envelope in here. Let's take a look at the envelope. It says, greetings, Agent JC. Z from one of your YouTube followers. I love the channel. I work for Pratt & Whitney at the West Palm Beach R&D facility. Sounds like he's got a pretty cool job. I know you are more of a GE Rolls-Royce guy. Well, that's only because that's what I work on. The only reason I haven't worked on a Pratt & Whitney is because one hasn't showed up at the door. They're great. Actually, I touched a J52 for a day. I wouldn't call that working on it, but we just don't see Pratt & Whitney's, and I don't know why. But I would appreciate, I figured you would appreciate some jet engine swag that is not available to the general public. This is not a plug for P&W, but more of an appreciation of the hard work that you do. Thanks again, Afterburner 119. Afterburner 119, why did he pick that name? You guys can let me know in the comments what you think. I have an idea, and I'm sure it's similar to yours. Afterburner 119 is lead mechanic, engineering, and validation at the West Palm Beach R&D for Pratt & Whitney. Don't they make rocket engines there? Space shuttle main engine? I'd like to see one of those. And what's in here? What is in here? Holy cow. Stickers galore. We've got one of the coolest stickers of any company. I like that. And then it looks like about 50 different stickers from space shuttle missions. So maybe he does make the SSME. 123. I can't go through all of these, but amazing. Pratt & Whitney space shuttle. Oh, and satellite. Is that a satellite? Or is that, that's STS-125, I think. STS-126. 127. 128. 128, 13, 134, 129, 101, lots of them. There's a whole stack. Thanks for that and some more really cool stickers. I was amazed at the, it looks almost exactly like this. When I was at the Planes of Fame Museum and other air museums and at the secret Texas Warbird Aerospace facility, the Pratt & Whitney R2800 and R1340 has a beautiful metal and enamel badge of this right on the front of the engine crankcase. It's beautiful. They haven't changed their decal in a long time. Okay, now let's get to the contents of the box. This just showed up out of nowhere. I can't believe this. This is super fantastic. Okay, what does that say? Engine assembly and test. Anybody name that plane? That one's a hard one. That's a hard one. Pratt & Whitney, dependable engines. We support our troops. Right on. Beautiful. It's even my size. Okay. There's more. There's more. Pratt & Whitney engine assembly and test, F-135 JSF. I wonder if the F-135 is the engine in the F-35. I'm guessing it is. Not knowing a lot about Pratt & Whitney engines, that's a guess on my part. And a red one. These are going to be great for wearing at the test cell to stay warm while we're testing a jet engine. Engine test. F-35B ship trials. We don't have engine test cell t-shirts, but we might have to think about that. The last one, Pratt & Whitney engine test. That is super cool. So let me get this right here. Afterburner 119, thank you very much. This is all fantastic, and I don't know what to say, but you let me know. Let me know what I can do for you, buddy. We're up here in the snow in northern, actually we're in middle Canada, Northern Canada is like the North Pole. But it's below zero right now, and it's nice, sunny, but it's not Florida. So nice to get something from Florida, and I will be using this every day. Florida test site. If you got any pictures of you guys working on the job in the test cell, send them. And post videos of what you guys can do. Or maybe you're working in a more secure facility because you work with modern engines and you can't film the stuff that you work on. The stuff that we work on is 50 years old or more, so it's not exactly a secret. So we film everything, or I try to film as much as I can. As part of our midweek bonus, let's crank up a 1500. Bright sunny day, still a bit of snow around. Walter's on the start cart. So this is a midweek special bonus, and I'd like to thank you, Mr. Coverstone, sorry about that. Afterburner 119, thanks a lot, really appreciate this. Don't know what to say, and thanks for watching.